James Fergusson Architect. James Fergusson FRS 22 January 1808-9 January 1886 was a Scottish-born architectural historian, mainly remembered for his interest in Indian historical architecture and antiquities. He was an important figure in the 19th century rediscovery of ancient India. He was originally a businessman, and though not formally trained as an architect, designed some buildings and decorative schemes. Life, education, and India. Fergusson was born in Ayr, the son of William Fergusson 1773-1846, an army surgeon. After being educated first at the Royal High School, Edinburgh, and then at a private school in Hounslow, he went to India to work as a trader at his family's mercantile house of Fairley Fergusson and Company of Calcutta. Here, he became interested in the remains of the ancient architecture of India, little known or understood at that time. The successful conduct of an indigo factory, as he states in his own account, enabled him to retire from business after about 10 years and settle in London. His observations on Indian architecture were first published in his book on the rock-cut temples of India, published in 1845. The task of analyzing the historic and aesthetic relations of this type of ancient buildings led him further to undertake a historical and critical comparative survey of the whole subject of architecture in the illustrated How. Being a concise and popular account of the different styles of architecture prevailing in all ages and countries, a work which first appeared in 1850, it was followed in 1862 by one entitled A History of the Modern Styles of Architecture, being a sequel to the Handbook of Architecture. The 1855 work was reissued 10 years later in a much more extended form in 3 volumes, under the title of A History of Architecture in All Countries from the Earliest Times to the Present Day. The chapters on Indian architecture, which had been considered at rather disproportionate length in the handbook, were removed from the general history, and the whole of this subject treated more fully in a separate volume, The History of Indian and Eastern Architecture, which appeared in 1876, as the 4th volume to the History of Architecture. The 1876 work was later revised with additions by James Burgess and Richard Feme Spears in 1910 and published in 2 volumes. United Kingdom. In 1849, Fergusson published a metaphysical study, Historical Inquiry into the True Principles of Beauty in Art, more especially with reference to architecture. Some of his essays on special points in archaeology, such as the treatise on the mode in which light was introduced into Greek temples, included theories on Greek temples, which did not receive general acceptance. Like many of his contemporaries, Fergusson was concerned about British preparedness to resist a French invasion, and he published an essay on a proposed new system of fortification, with hints for its application to our national defenses, 1849, The Peril of Portsmouth, or French Fleets and English Forts, 1852, and Portsmouth Protected. In 1859, he was the only civilian appointed to the Royal Commission on the Defense of the United Kingdom, which subsequently recommended a huge program of coastal fortifications that became known as Palmerston's Follies. He received the Gold Medal of the Royal Institute of British Architects in 1871. Among his works, besides those already mentioned, are Palaces of Nineveh and Persepolis Restored 1851, Mausoleum at Halicarnassus Restored 1862, Tree and Serpent Worship 1868, Rude Stone Monuments in All Countries 1872, and the Temples of the Jews and the Other Buildings in the Harem. The sessional papers of the Institute of British Architects include papers by him on the history of the pointed arch, architecture of southern India, architectural splendor of the city of Bijapur, on the Erechtheum, and on the Temple of Diana at Ephesus. Although not a prolific practicing architect, a small number of examples of Fergusson's architecture remain in existence, the most notable of which are the Parliament Building of Jamaica and the Marion North Gallery in Kew Gardens. Fergusson was advisor with Austin Henry Layard in the scheme of decoration for the Assyrian court at the Crystal Palace, and in 1856 assumed the duties of general manager to the Crystal Palace Company, a post which he held for 2 years. In 1866, he was a member of a committee to advise Henry Scott on design aspects of the Royal Albert Hall, along with architects William Tite and Matthew Digby Wyatt, and the engineers John Hawkshaw and John Fowler. In 1847, the burden of this contention was further explained by the publication, in 1860, of his notes on the site of the Holy Sepulchre at Jerusalem and the temples of the Jews and the other buildings in the Harem area at Jerusalem, published in 1878, which was a further elaboration of these theories, which are said to have been the origin of the establishment of the Palestine exploration. Fergusson died in London on 9 January 1886 and is buried with his father on the west side of Highgate Cemetery. Selected publications. Fergusson, James. An Historical Inquiry into the True Principles of Beauty in Art, More Especially with Reference to Architecture, 1849. Fergusson, James. An Essay on a Proposed New System of Fortification, with Hints for Its Application to Our National Defenses, 1849, London, John Wheel. Fergusson, James. The Illustrated Handbook of Architecture, 1855, London, John Murray. Vol. I and Vol. Roman II. Fergusson, James. Tree and Serpent Worship, or Illustrations of Mythology and Art in India, 1868, London, W. H. Allen and Company. Fergusson, James. Rude Stone Monuments in All Countries, 1872, London, John Murray, Albemarle Street. Fergusson, James. History of the Modern Styles of Architecture, 1891. New York, Dodd Mead. Vol. I and Vol. Roman II. Fergusson, James, et al. History of Indian and Eastern Architecture, 2nd edition, 1910. London, J. Murray. Vol. I and Vol. Roman II,